I'm writing a paper on global health in Liberia for my class of FYE. First, I'm gonna open up Word, Microsoft Word. Then I'm gonna open up Internet Explorer. The first place I'm gonna look for information at is Google Scholars. Because their information needs to be credible. So I'm gonna search Liberia. The history of Liberia, just to get a little bit of information about the history. I'm gonna scroll through. Well, I'm finna filter out the ones that are too old because information changes. Now I'm just trying to find something that's relevant to the history. Everything they used to talk about Ebola. Well, that is a, I guess, a good place to start because that's part of the health of Liberia. I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna open up a new tab to change my search terms because I wasn't finding what I was looking for. So I'm just gonna look up the regular history. Well, not the regular history, the health of Liberia. I'm using the World Health Organization because their information is credible. I would take all these statistics and compile them into an essay, well, paragraph into my essay or research paper. Another major part of the paper is women's health as a separate topic, so I'm gonna search that. Just to get specific information. I was told to stay away from .org because sometimes they can be trying to sell you things. I'm gonna go back to the Google Scholar and look up women's health. When doing research, especially on very specific topics, a lot of times they are not found in Google Scholar, so you have to revert back to regular Google or Yahoo. These seem like some good articles, so I will open it, read it, especially if it's a .org, make sure it's not trying to sell anything, or make you join an organization. After I have read it, I would summarize it. Or maybe use a quote from it. Then go back into other sites that were found when I looked it up. And read those also. this looks like a good source, so I would copy and paste the website into my Word document to come back to later. And write a brief description up under it. More or less do an annotated bibliography. An annotated source, I guess. When annotating the site, I would also add, I write the description of it. Well, first I would put this into the citation machine. That's the one I use, or EasyBib. I would choose the APA format because that's the way paper is supposed to be written. No, I don't want that. I guess I won't use EasyBib. I'm going to choose APA format again because that's the way we have to write our paper. Choose website because it's not a journal, it's more of a website article.